Of all the people we regularly invite into our lounge rooms via the telly, actress June Salter was right up there as one of our all-time favourites. Whether she was making us laugh in satirical sketch comedies or keeping us on the edge of our seats every week in the soapies, June had that certain something that endeared her to us all.
You must remember this. A kiss is just a kiss.
June Salter was born to be an actress. Growing up in Sydney, the only subject she ever liked at school was drama. She put that love of acting to work first in radio and then on stage. But it would be an exciting new medium called television where she'd really shine.
Excuse me, do you like the Mavis Branson show? Oh, you do? And who's your favourite star? June Salter, good.
Although Mavis Branson made June a household name, her marriage to fellow actor John Mellion always came first. They were the equivalent of showbiz royalty, but in 1971, the marriage ended dramatically. By her side through all of this was her best pal and confidant, Gwen Friend.
There's a nice photo of Salt.
Why is it that you like that photo particularly?
I don't know. It's got a warmth and a friendliness, and it's all three of us.
Yeah.
It's nice.
Yeah. Now, when did you first meet June Salter?
When she first came into radio.
And you've been friends ever since?
That's right. And we shared a house when Salt's marriage broke up with Johnny Mellion. And John Jr. was just a little fella. We decided to pool resources and share a house. And we shared a house together with Jim and Salt and I for 40 years.
It's quite a long union, isn't it? Was she generally very easy to get along with?
Wonderful. Great friend, wonderful sense of humour. And, of course, the deep-cut velvet voice was unbelievable.
Incredible voice.
Glorious voice. Marvellous singing voice.
Your head in. Will this record never end? How on earth can I expect to entertain my friend?
She danced, played the piano.
She did it all, really, didn't she?
She did the lot.
Opportunity doesn't knock.
It walks right in.
I'm going to start by just trying to get a nice bright pink ground onto this, and then somehow work out where June's going to fit. Recall Miss Friend telling us about a certain type of lighting that they use on the stage. Bastard amber and a surprise pink. This is soft lighting. Just got this idea that I'd like something very theatrical. It's a terrible admission, but sometimes when I look at my palette, I think it looks a lot more spontaneous and interesting than what goes onto the canvas. Now, who are these two little friends?
That's Gull. That was Junie's.
Mm.
And that's Wall, and he's mine. But Gull is probably the best travelled gollywog in the whole world.
He travelled with June everywhere.
Everywhere.
When you're painting a portrait of someone posthumously, you don't have the privilege of actually being able to meet the person and talk to that person.
Meet the
find
light
out
behind them.
Yes. You obviously would have an image of June Salter in your head. If you look at that image, what age would she be?
Probably about 45, 40 to 45.
That's very specific. Why do you say that?
Well, I think it was the best when she was looking her very best.
Does this mean that we're going to smell of bait for the rest of the day?
Ah, spinner. No mess, no smell. We're going after Taylor. They'll have a go at anything that moves.
All males, are they?
She was getting accolades and awards and she was happy and on top of the world, you know?
Was that the best period of her life?
Oh, no. Having her son was the best period of her life. And being with him and adoring him, that was her absolute.
June and her son John shared an especially close bond.
There's nothing like a Chinese feed, is there, John?
No, there certainly is not, and this is a particularly good one. When you come to this place now, does it bring back memories of Mum?
Yeah, it does. I mean, so often she would arrive by cab. Yeah. I'd get here first and I would wait at the bar for her. And she'd arrive by cab, I'd open the door for her. And just to see the joy on her face about coming and having lunch with her son.
Well, tell me about what about later impressions? Or what do you remember as her happiest years?
I think when she was, you know, in the midst of restless years, she was working, she was busy, she was happy, she was up, she was doing lots of things. And, I mean, apart from doing television, of course, she had such a wonderful career in the theatre. I mean, doing Crown Matrimonial was one of the, you know, joyous things of her life, and she got to do it a number of times.
But to get to an image, a couple of ideas have occurred to me. Like, one would be to have her in a fairly domestic sort of setting. Or do we go the other way and present her as the quintessential actress slash show type person?
The picture of her as Queen Mary in Crown Matrimonial, that very regal thing, that almost grande dame kind of thing, she sort of had that aura about her. A lot of people were intimidated by her because she was very correct, she was very proper, she was always immaculately turned out. She was forthright in a lot of instances. She didn't suffer fools gladly in any way, shape or form.
I'm a great fan. She was good.
Actor and friend Stuart Wagstaff gave me another perspective.
My favourite moment of all, and this is true of a lot of actors and actresses in particular, is when they play royalty.
Mm-hmm.
They become royal, no matter how much they're aware of this at the beginning. And like every other actress who plays a queen, she started, hello, almost doing that. And on one occasion, we were working together on a telethon or something like that, and they announced June, and I said, hello, June. She said, how do you do it? So I thought, the hell with it. I dropped a deep curtsy. And she was very cross and then finally laughed at it.
The idea that I've got is I'd like it to be as colourful as possible. And have June, while dressed as Queen Mary, in the very austere costume she wore in that role, have her still looking like she's anything but austere, anything but queenly, and you're just sitting there and enjoying a cup of tea. It's no wonder that June played the Queen Mary so well, and it's probably also important, as a committed Republican, that I curb my natural cartooning instincts and don't turn this into a parody on the strength of that. Hands do say a lot about the subject, I reckon. Just like the way a person stands and the way a person moves. June's got very sort of, I don't know, quite strong, big hands. They look to me like they more or less confirm a lot of the things that John said about her. And really, the strong hands of a person who knew a bit of hard work.
Basically, from the age of, what, 8, she raised me as a single mum. And during that time, she would oftentimes be working 2 jobs. She was working at the Bull and Bush from 8 o'clock at night till midnight at the same time as doing television, which would have her up at 5 o'clock the following morning, and she did that for years on end.
What's that old expression? The best way to kill time is to work it to death?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I mean, she absolutely loathed sitting around. But, yeah, when she was busy, when she was working her ass off, you know, she was vibrant, happy, alive.
You're so London, you're so Kensington Gardens, and I'm so warm blue.
From watching June on the Mavis Bramston show, I can now see it was the perfect vehicle to showcase her many talents. It was also where she first met Carol Rae.
She was lovely to work with. She wasn't, she'd do her share. And if it was your laugh, give you the feed line so you've got your laugh.
You got any idea what it's like going through life looking like a roll your own? It's not much fun, mate.
And June also could do the sort of humour which to me is quintessentially Australian, and that is the laconic thing.
And I'm so
You know, I've heard lots of other stories about June. This Australianness thing, it sort of sums her up in a way that I haven't been able to before.
It's not my business, but I wouldn't paint her as Queen Mary, because although she was wonderful and could have been Queen Mary, but I just think June herself...
Well, that's what I'm after.
..was a really lovely person, and all those things were in her persona. I mean, obviously you'd capture her if she was here, bless her heart.
You know what? I'm in more trouble than Speed Gordon. I want her looking really nice and relaxed. And she does. But for some reason, I don't sort of... It's fairly difficult to work out exactly how she's positioned here. I might have to start this all over again and completely change the drawing. Hello, Miss Friend.
Hello, Bill. How are you doing?
I've finally started the portrait of June.
Yay.
What do you think if I was to put her with a sort of really friendly, relaxed expression on her face and holding a cup of tea, but giving her the Queen Mary outfit,
right,
playing that part but being herself?
Yeah, it's tricky.
It is tricky.
Queen Mary, and I don't think you're going to get June Salter.
Okay. Maybe it would be better just to forget that altogether and have her looking as relaxed and informal as I can get her.
That's right.
What do you think of it, Gus? Pretty crook? I think I've just made an absolute mess of this. I reckon when something is as dead as that, there's only one decent thing to do with it, and that is to bury it. Well, as June Salter would say, thank you and good night. I had a terrible night last night. After making such a hash of things yesterday, because all I could think about was, what do I need in order to be able to make a decent fist of this picture of June? And all I could think about was, well, I really just need someone to sit for me. Pleased that I thought of Charlie just around the corner. I thought, she's probably about the right size and the right shape. You know, suddenly I could get some kind of idea of how to proceed and where the picture would go, or at least how it would start. Usually I really enjoy the experience of just, you know, improvising a drawing, more or less out of my head. But it's always helpful to have good reference, especially if what you want to finish up with is an image that's really convincing, and that's what I need this one to be.
The first thing that June did when she got a character to read and think about how she was going to play it, a lot of people do a lot of things about a lot of characters, but it was the walk. Now, once Salt got the walk of the character, that was, she built on that. If it was an energetic character with an energetic walk, or a sad walk.
It's very interesting, because that's the basis of all your body language, really, the
that's
way
right.
that you walk. Yeah, she'd get that right and the rest would follow.
Oh, yes.
portrait has to completely convince. The image has to convince. Maybe there's a bit of a parallel there too. I mean, it's hardly getting the walk right, but if I can just get that attitude where she's kind of just really relaxed, that will say something about her. Tell you what, I'm feeling a lot better already.
Everyone I've spoken to about your mum has talked of her generosity. She really was a generous person, wasn't she?
Exceedingly generous.
If you wrote her a letter, you got a reply. If you have a birthday, you get a card. Christmases, birthdays, Easters, any time when there was any significant event, anniversary, she knew them all. She would always do that, and just little notes, little thoughts.
She was genuine. She was worried if you were sick. She was upset if you were upset. She could be funny and pull you together. Oh, come on, she'd say, you know, stop all that faffing about. I mean, she was just lovely.
Another story that sort of underpinned this idea that June was an incredibly generous person, I reckon the one that says most about her, was the fact that she turned her back on a burgeoning and quite brilliant career in order to follow John to England.
I know we bid her a tearful farewell, and we had a little do for her. We'd all clubbed together and we gave her a black handbag. I always remember. And she was such a softy, June, you know.
Was she?
She was in tears. We were in tears. I mean, she, by then, had made a huge success in the Bramston show, and it was the top-rating television programme.
Yes.
But without a moment's thought, she upped stakes and...
Is it surprising, really, isn't it? It's surprising.
And that was June. That there's a real, real person inside there.
Yeah, thinking about June's generosity, and the generosity of spirit that she showed, and she loved somebody like she obviously loved John Mellion, her husband, then she was prepared to put up with a lot from him.
She tried and tried and tried to get him to, you know, give it up, to go to Alcoholics Anonymous, to keep away from the hard-living boys, the hard-drinking boys, to sort of come home and have some family life, perhaps. His talent, he really did waste. Very sad.
Was it must have been terribly sad for June as his wife.
Oh, dreadful, because she adored
him.
She
watched this happening.
Worshipped him.
Mm.
Absolutely adored him.
I reckon she would have carried that sadness with her. And in some of the photos that you see of years, I don't know if you imagine these things, you read them into it or not, but it seems to be there.
When he left, she couldn't fall in a heap because of Johnny. He had to be kept in school and in clothes and fed and housed and whatnot, educated, you know. So she just said, oh, righto, here we go again.
A very difficult balance for someone doing the sort of work that she was doing.
Very difficult.
Was she a highly emotional person? Because she had this great range as an actress, didn't she?
Very emotional. Anything that was a bit sad,
So a lot of things made her laugh, but a lot of things made her cry.
Oh, yes. But while she was crying, I'd say to her, oh, Salt, really? And she'd start to laugh as well, you know.
And who would think the man I loved was quite so handsome, quite so tall.
Now, I reckon that's starting to look a bit more like June. There's just this really relaxed attitude about it. That's what I want to get. I reckon that's pretty much what she'd be like too if she came into the studio, sat down,
Let's face it, she was the consummate actress.
Hey, Phil, mate! You up?
Bruce! Hey, how are you, mate?
Oh, she's old. I'm sorry.
That's all right, mate. Come here.
I know you're a film. Moon Soldier.
Yeah,
doesn't look like it. Well, it doesn't.
Well, I know it doesn't at the moment, but it will. They go through some...
I worked with her.
Did you?
Hmm.
Oh, you better sit down. Tell me a bit about her, because I'm having a lot of trouble here. What was she like backstage? Was she happy sort of person?
Yeah, she's good fun.
Yeah,
she's good fun. Yeah, every night after the show, you know, we'd go and have a drink somewhere. She liked to have a scotch. And she had a really deep-throated voice, a beautiful, beautiful stage and radio voice. Fabulous woman. Really, really nice woman. Yeah.
And a so fabulous nice picture except for the head.
Yeah, well, you're not cooking with gas there, Bill Barrow, I'll tell you now. Such a hard face.
Yeah, it's a hard room too.
And there was a wonderful, wonderful, sexy warmth to her that you've got to get in that face.
Yeah.
She had such a welcoming sort of a look, you know. She was a lovely woman.
Oh, well, I haven't done her justice yet, but I'll...
God love you, darling.
I'll be working on it. Thanks, Bruce.
Not you. I was talking to...
Something cool I'd like to order. Something cool.
Legend is the story of the life of a saint. Well, a saint I ain't. But legends do go back a long way, so I suppose I can qualify for that.
Yes, I'd like something
cool. Towards the end, when she wasn't well, and of course she'd always smoked. In fact, I used to envy her, this deep, sexy voice.
You attribute it to the smoky, do you?
Well, in retrospect, I did, you know, because it didn't help her towards the end of her life. But she died too young, and she was a great loss.
She had enormous courage, as when she was told she had cancer. You know, she said, oh, well, we'll just have to cope with it, won't we? And that was it, you know. But when she went to hospital, she took her little friend with her.
I've been given a lot of information about June Salter from the people that I've spoken to. And I'm just thinking that she was a really fascinating, interesting woman. I must admit, this one has given me a lot of trouble. It really worries me, this one. There's just something about it. You know what? I'm not gonna sign this picture. Quite often, you know, the first idea you have is the best and you should bloody well stick with it, and I didn't. Frankly, I think I've wasted my time with this one, so out you go. Right, at the moment of truth, here it is, my portrait of June.
That's not what I expected.
No?
I know we discussed it.
Yeah.
What happened to the sexy one?
I didn't tell you that I'd start another one.
No. You lied.
Yeah, well, I did. I started another one entirely. I did another version of it before, John. And I actually finished the first version, but just wasn't happy with the whole idea of it. So I went back to my original idea, which was this one.
I don't mind it.
You like it?
Yeah, I like it, yeah. To me, it couldn't possibly be anyone else. Also, it's a slight caricature.
Yeah. I think there's no doubt about that.
Yeah, the eyes, the face is emphasised just that bit. It's
almost as if she should say something.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'll tell you what, funny too.
What's she saying?
Oh, I wouldn't like to think. Look in those eyes.
Good.
Just,
oh, yeah, isn't
just dead right.
That's pretty unmistakable. Yeah.
Come on, Venables, let's go to the bar and have a scotch. She'd say that every night when I finished that. Come on, love. Up for a scotch. We'll go for a scotch.
Good.
She's a lovely woman. Bloody lovely woman. She really was.